everyone. It's Vicky, and I am so cold. My nose is still even red because I was just outside with my chickens freezing. And if you didn't know, or if you don't follow me on Instagram, my family and I got chickens this year in the spring. So this is our first winter in Chicago with them. And it is literally, I think, 13 degrees when I went out there. So yeah, it's dang cold. But today I am here to wish you a happy new year, happy 2022, which is so crazy to have lived to this point, right? I remember when it was 2000 and I graduated high school and it was the whole Y2K thing and we all thought we were gonna die. Anyway, today I'm gonna talk about the Techo Kaigi. And Techo Kaigi is a term I first heard, I believe, from Job in Job's Journal, and also from the Stationery Cafe, April from Penguins Creative, and Kelly Loves Letters. I remember hearing them talk about this, and I thought it was such a great term, and I love the concept of the translation of it from Japanese is really discussing your plans for your planners and your journals for the year. So Techo Kaigi is what we're going to do today, and I thought it'd be so much fun to share this with all of you. I also want to share that I've already shared all of this, and I do put out probably 2 to 3 videos a week over on my Patreon, so if you guys would want to join me over there, I would so greatly appreciate your support over there. It's a closer community, and we can chat. You guys can request whatever you want over there, so I have that link down below. I'd love to see you there if you would be so kind and to join me over there. First planner I'm gonna bring up here, guys, is this right here. This is a Franklin Covey classic sized planner. I have inside, or I did all of last year, I had used the Franklin Covey Carrera inserts, the marble ones. Very beautiful aesthetic, very pretty. This year I have them again, but I found an alternative from At a Glance on Amazon, and I love the 2-page per day like look and the way that I've been utilizing it for notes and for memory keeping. It's really been a great format, and I actually probably can say I have used it all year. Last year I used it in the classic size, and then I went down to a compact, which is kind of the equivalent of a personal size. And I was really, really happy with the system, extremely happy with it. I'm gonna continue with it this year. I think I'm gonna flip-flop between these At-a-Glance planners as well as the Franklin Covey Carreras, but it's basically the exact same. And I'll show you guys a sample page here of, I kind of utilize it with Post-its, so you can kind of see it that way, as well as I add photos on here to just kind of help me keep my memory keeping alive, because I know I'm jotting things down relatively quickly in there, and I sometimes have to do memory keeping like a few days later, so my memory isn't always up to snuff. So this has really been a great system. I've loved it. I love the zip around. I do have a binder coming from Franklin Covey soon, but I think there's a shipment delay on it, so it's not here just yet, but I'm excited for that one. And I love this white kind of, it's got like a snakeskin kind of, you can hear the texture on there. I got this pre-loved, and yeah, I really like it. So that's my first one. My next one, I think I have a theme here with the color white. This is my Roterfaden, and I'm not gonna pretend how to say the second half of that, the texture, you guys know what I'm talking about. I love Roterfaden. This is my second Roterfaden. I have another one that has the red string on it. This I just picked up an extra elastic because I lost the one that I actually initially had for it. This one doesn't come, it's a limited edition in a white color, and there was a beautiful yellow one as well. And they have inside, what I was really, really drawn to was the cornflower blue suede on the inside. It's so delicious. Even this leather is so delicious. And Roterfaden had shared on their Instagram, I think it was on their Instagram, that you can actually clean this if it gets dirty with the magic eraser. You just kind of wipe it down. I have just a few scuffs on it, but nothing terrible. The leather on this feels so good, though. It's a really good feeling leather, nice and lightweight. I felt like the other Roterfaden that I have is a little heftier in weight. This leather is super light, super pliable, easy to have, and I really love it. Inside of it, what I have in here is the Midori horizontal layout. Or no, it's not even. It's just monthly. Sorry, it's just the monthly. You guys all notice that all my planners, all my journals have basically a monthly in there. It just helps me keep a timestamp on life. So I like having the some format of a calendar in there. So that's all that's in there, and I just kind of keep dates and things in here. This is the Jibun Techo Days. This is my first year using a Jibun Techo Days. Last year I was utilizing my digital journal, which I'm experimenting with. It's kind of a concept that my Patreons have seen it, but I have not done anything like it. I've been digitally since June documenting my life, and I'm almost done with doing it and catching up. And what I'm going to do is like use Shutterfly or one of those services to print the book out and kind of see what it looks like. But I've been journaling in there like I do on paper, except I'm doing it on my iPad. So I'm excited to see how that turns out. But I also had a Midori MD day per page that I was using in an A5 size to kind of keep all the like stubs, tickets, things you collect in life. You kind of want to put it somewhere, and I thought that Jibun Techo Days would be kind of a fun one to go with. So all I have in the front cover here is from Animal Crossing when for the new year, when Isabel came and greeted me for the new year, which was really fun. And basically all this is going to be is just that memory keeping. Now this first page here, it gives you on JetPens a translation of what each of these kind of stands for. I just took like old Erin Condren stickers and put my own things in here, like the podcast I listen to, music I listen to, just kind of for memory keeping sake. I like looking back on that stuff. I think it's fun, and really just having fun in here and documenting and gluing and things like that. It's like an AVEC in that it has two books that are associated with it. And then these guys, these bookmarks are from, I can't remember, A Strange Dream, maybe? She makes them on Etsy. This one's from her as well, and I don't see her name on there. I think it's something like A Strange Dream. They're just creepy bookmarks that I just love. This notebook is kind of like a brain dump, write everything down. But what I love about it is it has 2mm grid inside, as well as cream paper, which is my all-time favorite. So I just kind of keep notes in here, and you know, I did put some pictures and stuff in here. So just kind of my old school bullet journal format. I have a couple of bullet journals, I guess, that I go with. So wherever I feel like writing down notes, and you guys are probably familiar with the Roterfaden in that it has these metal clips. This little file folder that I have from Rowena from Sojourner, it's closed down here at the bottom, so I can use only a clip here at the top, and it's in the middle of this book. And so I glued from Retail Bunker my leather like name thing so I could put a pen in here. I just glued it to that folder from Rowena, and it's in the middle of this notebook. And then I just have stuck in the back here just the Hobonichi board, and then the sticker release book, which I don't have filled yet. I plan on filling it with stickers so that I more readily utilize them, because I feel like I have so many stickers, I don't utilize them enough. And then there's a zip pocket here in the back, which there's nothing in there, but it's this cornflower blue is so pretty. I just love it so much. So that's my Roterfaden. I've really been loving and enjoying it. Just lightweight. It's got everything in there. I just took like an elastic and put it around there just so it kind of sort of keeps everything together. I just found that if your elastic's too tight, it kind of like bends the leather a little, I don't know, a little too much for me, but I love it. I'm curious to see how that wears the white on there. And then I think I shared on Instagram that I finally found the Tig Mod, which I believe the company actually went out of business a few years back, which I had no idea. I had been looking for a Tig Mod for years, and I finally got one, a used one on, I think eBay, somewhere like that. And if you're not familiar with Tig Mod, this was the rage probably back in 2015, 16, somewhere around there. Everyone wanted one of these, and it was just basically like a carrier for all of your stationery. There were so many beautiful aesthetic pictures on Instagram of people putting like all their pens and notebooks and your ear. I don't think you had the wireless buds just yet for your ears, but like, you know, your Apple headphones that everyone had, and it was just all organized so beautifully in here. And I've always wanted one, and I finally got my hands on a used one. So I've been using this on and off this past year, and all it really has been is a really nice kind of like, I don't know, place to store knickknackers, but also I have so much stuff on my desk. I did have all my fountain pens in here, and I just cleaned them all out and put new ink in for the new year, So this will have all my fountain pens. I have a little field notes. I've been utilizing the field notes primarily for menu keeping, grocery lists, that kind of fun stuff. Any note taking. Sometimes if I'm listening to a podcast in the car or anything like that, and I want to make a note, this is something great to just kind of jot it down in. This will fit a cell phone. Right now I just have a stencil in here. Just a stencil. The whole appeal was this like magnetic snap kind of closure. That was the whole, if you remember, the Tig Mod thing. Then I have my plotter, which I will talk about in just a second here. I have a friction pen. I don't have anything in the zipper just yet. I have a little pad, and then I have my Midori in here. It's got two sections actually in here, so there's lots of room to kind of bulk this up. But I don't want it like too heavy. Inside of my plotter, which is new to the U.S., I think in November, I think they were available here in the United States. In Japan, it's been, I don't believe they're new at all. There's a lot of beautifully aesthetic photos of the plotter system on Instagram. I highly recommend you go check them out. I did not see a lot of videos using the plotter in English, but a lot of them in Japanese, I believe. And the appeal of the system is this beautiful brass, like metal binding mechanism, I guess you can call it. And the idea of this is just simplicity, beauty, and it's surprisingly, if you get one, you'll be shocked at how much you're gonna love it. And I know the appeal, but I can't express the appeal of how much I love this. This is in a size called the Bible size. It's not the personal size. There is a personal size. This Bible size is, so if I compare it to like my Roterfaden, to give you an idea, it kind of reminds me of the personal size traveler's notebooks that were really popular a little while back. I feel like when Foxy Fix was a trend and everything, everyone was in that personal size. This kind of reminds me of it, but they call it a Bible size. Personal size is a slightly more narrow, and then they have an A5 size, and then I think like a smaller like pocket size. The leather is beautiful. It smells really, really nice and luxe. And inside, no matter what, this lies so flat and so nice. And the paper in here is superb. I feel like if Hobonichi picked this up, since Tomoe River is going away, I don't think the world would be disappointed. I think they'd be pretty happy because the paper is really top notch. Takes fountain pen, ballpoint, you name it, takes it really beautifully. The ring mechanism, you'll notice though, is extremely tiny, and that is purposeful. It's to really minimize the amount of stuff you carry with you and just keep it strictly to the things that you need, which I love. I love that so much because what it forces me to do is go through the system and make sure I'm only keeping things I need. So what I did was I got the plotter inserts for monthlies. So I started using this in December, and I just have a monthly section in here. The paper itself is actually designed where the rings are to not tear. So it's heavy duty, so it does not tear, which I think is really, really sexy. I love that. I have all of my monthlies in here, I believe until March or April, till March. And then I basically have another kind of running conscious stream of thought, or sort of that whole bullet journal style. They also sell these cute business card like flippy floppers that I just put recipes on, little knickknacks, little notes, and I kind of pop them in here. But this is, again, such beautiful quality and so well done. The paper is incredible. You can see I put a recipe in here. It just allows for my eye to catch different things. I had my Christmas card lists here, Christmas gifts in here, different recipes, different ideas, my daughter's birthday guest list, where we were gonna have it, so that when I archive this, it'll be archived and I can either put tabs on it or kind of work that out. I did an Animal Crossing themed birthday party for my daughter, so I kind of drew out some ideas there, and these are all going to come out because they are no longer of use to me. So they'll all come out, get archived, and I will put in new sheets. And I mean, I just love, I put in ideas for New Year's Eve here. And then what's another beautiful concept is they sell this like filing mechanism where you have a section to keep all of your project notes. So what's beautiful about that is if you were someone who is working with a team, you could technically take out this whole entire folder full of notes and whatever else you guys are working on, and you can give them all their information right there. If you're taking notes on certain projects, I made one here for myself with notes, and then I have another one in here. So you can really separate them and keep them in these little folders. There's also, I believe, a Gantt chart on here so that you can mark your progress. So if you're not a Gantt, is it a Gantt chart? No. Maybe, yeah. Where you can actually, where you're doing project management. And so you can really kind of monitor where you need to be and if you're on top of your projects, all that other kind of good stuff. So I love this system. I think it's so beautiful and perfect. I love that you get this little insert. There's so many great little accessories and the elastic fits flawlessly. I'm just gonna say that plotter is just flawless. Everything about it is really sexy, sleek, and chic. And I really like that a lot. The other item that I have in here is my Traveler's Company Fly to the World from Japan Traveler's Notebook. This was gifted to me. I have a little German Shepherd charm on here from Romani's Realm. She sent this to me when I lost Hanky, and so I like kind of keeping him here with me, and I just love it. I love this cover. I don't know where you can find these. Sorry for that. I'm sure you can find some on Etsy or eBay or some of those Facebook groups. I know I've had a few requests asking about it, but I haven't like really seen them readily available. I know kind of Traveler's Company comes out with these like special edition ones, and it's kind of hard to get your hands on some of these. Inside of here, I had another item that was gifted to me, and it's a leather folder, and it has a zip on the back. The insert that I have in here is a Traveler's Notebook refill blank insert. It just has 64 blank MB paper white in here, and I think it's a 003. I love this paper. It's so beautiful. And I really have just been utilizing this as like a journal, sketchbook. I used it a while back where I had documented, let's see, one of my patients that I was with. And S Town, still one of my absolute favorite podcasts. I love this podcast so much. It just turned me on to podcasts and I just loved it so much. So just this space to just get creative, doodle, journal, do whatever. And if I want to be kind of in that size, it's in here for me and I can utilize it. And then by having my fountain pens and stuff in here, I just love the Tig Mod. I love this and I'm so glad I got my hands on it. My next planner note taker is the Levenger Softfolio in the junior size. This Kelly green color is amazing. I love the Softfolios because they house our discs, but what's really nice is you can fold this over. It's nice and compact. You can keep it on the desk with you. I love to take this to any kind of meetings I have. So if I have meetings for my kids' school or anywhere else that I'm going off to, I always grab this, and I love the disc bound system. It's just one of my favorites. It's one I'm not ready to let go of. And inside of here, I have monthlies as well. So I just printed off some simple monthlies. I have a year at a glance. This just helps me keep on track. If we have meetings coming up or anything like that, I have the whole year of 2022 up till April in here. Or no, I don't. I have it all the way up until December 2022. I have the whole year. And then I basically have note pages in here. And the note pages, what I do is I open it wherever I need a blank sheet. I write down all my notes. And then what I do is I create tabs and I keep it in here for as long as I need it. There's a folder in the back here where I also have my kids' school for like the different roles and timeline of where things need to be while I'm on the parent board. And so that's what I take with me and I love it. Anytime I need any kind of like more professional outside of my social media, anything like that, I'm gonna kind of house it in here. And then my last but not least is my newest addition, and I'm really, really excited about this. I really wanted a Hobonichi Techo. I was missing having the Hobonichi Techo, and I went online and I found someone who was reviewing the Kinbor Techo, which is like an alternative that you can find on AliExpress of the Hobonichi Techo. I was fascinated. I'm like, I gotta see this. I gotta check it out. And so I got one. And within about 2 weeks, I got one, and I'm so in love with this. So this cover, first of all, oh, he's got little glasses, but they keep falling off, so I'm gonna have to adhere them on. But look at these glasses. So I have to glue it. Doesn't wanna stay. It just doesn't wanna stay on the notebook. They keep popping off, but how cute is that? So I'm gonna try and glue this on or sew it on or do something like with fabric glue to get that to stick, because it just won't. Unless the journal, when it gets fuller, maybe then it'll hold, but right now they just keep popping off. Look how cute. And then look at this little paw. It's so cute. The paw, and then there's a little pen loop here also where the little paw is. I just thought it was so darling. And this whole thing, I believe this is on sale right now on AliExpress for like $12 or $13. The actual notebook itself and the cover was also about $20 or less, so it's super inexpensive. You do have to wait a couple weeks. But to show you, this is, I love this thing. Look at that. So it is a beautiful leatherette cover. Kind of reminds me of the Miguel Ruiz journals that you can find at Barnes & Noble. And the inside of it, I'll do a more formal review for you guys, but just to give you an idea, the paper in here is phenomenal. It kind of reminds me of the Jibun Techo Biz, that like real slippery, slick, really nice paper. I love the fact that the monthlies don't have the quotes. I feel like they utilize the space a little bit better than Hobonichi does. But same concept, except it doesn't have the weeks in here. So it has your months and then only your days, and you don't have the weeks in here. So if you were someone who was looking to not have that in there, this could be a great option for you. It's really inexpensive, and you can buy them like the Avec with the two separate, or you buy the full book, which I did. It's the full book. It's still very lightweight. It's not heavy. Obviously, if I fill it up, it'll probably get a little heavier. You still have like your overview of the year in the beginning. You have less of the pages in the back that give you, so you can see you have the whole year for planning. The way that I'm utilizing this journal is for basically me and only me. So a lot of times what I'm doing with my planners and journals and bullet journals, I have in my head a lot of times that someone's gonna look at it, or I'm gonna show it on social media, and I'm very conscious of what I put on the pages. I do have a Dear Diary journal that I will write things in, or sometimes I will write in here like I have here. So last year I used my Cosmo Airlight, and then I also used like in a Hobonichi Techo A6, I would randomly pick days that were empty and I would Dear Diary journal in there. I have so many techniques that I utilize when I'm doing Dear Diary journaling that I still can be open and vulnerable, but feel like my privacy, if someone were to pick it up, wouldn't be violated. So this is gonna be like my everything that's just for me. Like I wanna pick this up, and if I wanna write about a TV show, if I wanna write about a book, if I'm upset with somebody, if I'm happy with somebody, if I wanna boast, gloat, feel good about myself, feel bad about myself, whatever, it goes in here, and it's just for my eyes only. So there's no pressure, there's nothing like that. I loved the teddy of this. I felt like it was so comforting to have that. And it, that can feel childish to some. To me, it's so important. Journals have been friends for me for many, many years, since I was a little girl, and it will continue to provide that relationship for me, because I love my journals. I love them. And this feels so good. It's like a Sherpa material. I'm not afraid of it getting dirty. I don't care if it does. It just shows its life. And that's it. I'm going to glue the eyeglasses on here, and I'm going to love it so, so much. It's got a little like pom-pom on here. And so those are my plans so far. You guys know me, you know I change things out very often, and I'm okay with that. I love it. I wouldn't want it any other way, and I'm gonna look forward to continuing to 2022 with these, and I'll probably add some more. I will do my best to try and get a few more videos up here on YouTube. The problem with YouTube, there's a few things. There's an issue with YouTube and posting videos on here. One of the big issues is a lot of times things get flagged, and then the videos don't end up going up, and they have to go under manual review. I don't know why, but the last year has been super challenging to get it up here. I don't know why. Like, I have no issues uploading on here and putting it on Patreon, but for some reason on here I do. I have a ton of issues. And then some of the other issues that I have on here is like copyright claims on music, which is, I'm using like free audio stuff, so I don't know where the issue is there. And then also I found that sharing pictures and personal moments in my journals has felt more safe to me to do it over on Patreon than over here on the World Wide Web, because everyone can see them. Whereas on Patreon, I have a smaller group of people that I kind of am in touch with. I know who's on there. I can have a better way and better sense of community on there. But I'm gonna do my best to try and get some videos out here for you guys. I know I have plans so far to put out about the Kinbor. So like to do a full extensive look into the Kinbor, compare it to the Hobonichi and give you guys an idea. I picked one up in the A6 size as well. And I really love that one also. And the cover on it is so cute. I'm so excited for that one. So I'm going to take a look at that one and a little more in depth. I'm also going to look at the Jibun Techo Days. I'm familiar with Jibun. I used one in 2015, the Weeks version, the original version. I used that and I loved it. And I wanted to do a comparison in that as well. I had it in the B6 Slim. I now have it in the A5 Slim size, and I really, really enjoy it. So I have some ideas moving forward, and I hope to get those videos out on over here on YouTube. And so I hope to see you guys more often and more often. And what else can I say? And hopefully bring you guys some inspiration for 2022. I think everyone is having a positive outlook on 2022 and hoping for all the best, as am I. So thank you guys so much for your support, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care. Bye bye.